the best I am. I be feeling like yes I am, I am. You know I'm the best I am. You be a fool to not take me as I am. Tell me I'm the best I am. I be feeling like yes I am, I am. You know I'm the best I am. You be a fool to not take me as I am.
What's up, YouTube? This is Jessica Karina coming to you with Jess Help 101. So I'm trying to be quiet about this because it's like 6:32 in the morning and Russell is still asleep. And yeah, I am up just trying to get my day started. Like, I haven't been able to wake up early and like go to the gym or anything, so I'm trying to get my routine back. And yeah, so I'm currently making coffee, so I'm just waiting for that to just brew. I've been really struggling, and there's my coffee. I've just been really struggling, and just I'm not sure why I'm struggling. So one advice I was given was just to get back on a routine of things, and I'm really usually good with routines, but for some reason I've just been out of it. So I am trying today to start out working out. Yeah, so that's one thing, just get on a routine and just try to push yourself to that to the best you can. But yeah, y'all, so I am back. It is actually my lunch break right now. It's getting hot in here and I just got done eating, so I just kind of wanted just to update y'all on my day. It's been okay. Like, nothing's bad has happened and I didn't expect anything bad to happen. I put some effort in how I look today, put on a little bit of makeup, did my atrocious eyebrows, and I am not a makeup artist at all, so just this little effort did me well. But I did take so much time doing my makeup that I forgot to take my allergy medicine, so I've been sneezing and wiping all this stuff off all day and trying to reapply. So that's been my day. No, it's cool though. Like, and even just saying that, it's like I really need to learn or like rewire my brain to just mend little parts of how I tell my story. Cause today has been straight. Like, today has been good. Nothing bad has happened, and I don't expect anything bad to happen. So while I'm recording this, let me go ahead and correct myself. So this morning I shared a little bit as to why I'm making this video. I've been struggling a bit, and when I mean struggling, I've just been feeling very disconnected with myself. Like, I know what it feels to be aligned, to be in my purpose, to be, you know, just satisfied in where I'm at. And I'm not at this current moment, and I'm not sure why. Like, nothing bad has happened to me, but I've been trying to like be inspired and just, you know, put myself in that space again. And I'm realizing that I am in my way. Like, I'm overthinking, as much as I say we need to control our thoughts. Like, I am so overthinking that I'm in my way of alignment. No one else is in my way. It's me. I'm in my way. So I am sharing like just my experience with this with y'all, just to see if this is something that you can relate to. I can share my ideas with you, or you could share what's working for you. Please let me know, because I'm still out here just kind of right now. Yeah, so today I put on today that this is going to be an amazing day. Like, I got enough sleep in, I ate a really good meal, I woke up this morning, drank my coffee, and actually went to the gym. That's been a struggle for the past month. I used to go to the gym almost every morning, and I don't know what happened, but you know what? I'm going to change that again. I want to be back in my routine of things and want to be in that routine, not making and trying to push myself to do these things, but like, because I want to, and then it just naturally happens. Yeah, and then I have something to look forward to. Next Friday is Good Friday, so our office is closed, and I went ahead and took a PTO day that Thursday, so I'm off Thursday and Friday, including the weekend. So I have only a 3-day work day next week, and so super excited about that. But just during the work day, and because we're responsible adults out here, just kind of what to do just to help out, just to take care of myself. Like, that's honestly what I need to do, just take care of myself. But the thing is, like, how do I take care of myself? So just spicing up, like, try to put some effort in how I look today, look presentable, feel presentable. So I'm trying and retelling my story a little bit at a time, trying not to be so negative, not be in my way. So I'll come back to you in a second. All right, so I just got home from work. So I am going to unwind. And the way I do that is going to disconnect myself. And I'm going into the fantasy land of Westeros and Game of Thrones. Because I am getting ready to watch this for next Sunday. It comes out Sunday. It was probably going to be, you know, I'll probably post this afterwards. But yes, so that's just something that I do to just kind of just disconnect in a good way. So I am like not so in my mind thinking things. And if I'm on social media, like things just like I keep thinking or I putting thoughts and my energy into the wrong things sometimes. I think that social media is always bad, but y'all know what I mean. That's another tip. Do something that just takes your mind off of whatever you're thinking about, you shouldn't be thinking about. So. All right, so it's the next day. And while I'm getting ready to drink my coffee and then go work out, just gonna wanna list things in my head that I'm thankful for. And I'm thankful for so much. Like, as I sit in my living room, I just always remember, I'm like, wow, I have a house. It's my house. I may be renting it, but I can't believe that I have a house, you know? And it just spirals off from there. It's like, I'm thankful for the place that I'm at, the ability to afford these things. And it doesn't always have to be materialistic. Like, I'm super thankful for the fact that I can wake up and be appreciative of this life. So that's how I want to start off my day. I want to start off my day being extremely thankful, being positive, and being a very appreciative. Because a lot of people don't have these things, so I want to be positive and thankful. It's called the Rampage of Appreciation. So let's start off today on a good note. All right, so I am on my way to work, and I wanted to do how I did yesterday, just kind of put some effort into how I look today, so that way if I look good, then I'll feel good. So it's working. I feel like I look, you know, presentable today. But yeah, so on my way to work sometimes, especially if I'm in a rut or if I need just kind of something to try to inspire me, I listen to Abraham Hicks. My therapist put me onto her, and I also have been looking at her, like watching some of her stuff on YouTube as well. She just kind of dives deep more into the law of attraction. And these particular CDs, and which you'll find on YouTube as well if you look her up, it's like seminars, and she do these Q&As with people that just, you know, real life scenarios, that, you know, real life issues and contrasts that you come through in life and how to address them. And it's such an amazing, like, response that she always gives. And so just that little bit of information that she gives, I like it. So I would suggest, you know, if you have like a long commute to work or anything just throughout your day, just, you know, kind of, again, detach yourself and disconnect yourself, but from like the normal like social media and no negativity of the world, and allow yourself to receive and hear, you know, good inspiring information. Some people like to listen to gospel music, some people like to listen to, you know, different sermons and different podcasts. For me, I just like listening to Abraham Hicks and her to explain more about the law of attraction and how it applies to your everyday scenarios. So try something like that. Just detach yourself and, you know, listen to how other people go through life and see how they work through things and see if that's something that could be applicable to you. So yeah, I'm about to listen to it. So see y'all second. So I was just listening to a CD and something just came to my mind to be like, breathe. I didn't realize that I was taking all of these short, anxious filled breaths. And I'm not sure if you're like me and you do that. I've talked to Russell about this before, that how I never realized that I don't even realize that I'm not even taking real breaths. Like, I'm just like so much into my mind and I'm thinking and I'm like just in my way and I'm not taking breaths. So what I mean is, be focused in the now. Stop overthinking, stop thinking about the future, stop thinking of different scenarios, stop thinking about the past, or how you can redo things. Like, take the time to be present in the now. Use all your senses. What do you smell? What do you feel? How do you feel? Like, what do you see? Just recognize what's in front of you, what's happening to you right now, and take a deep breath. Stop worrying about all these different things. So I just wanted to give that little tidbit of information. So be present, be in the now, and just be thankful and appreciative of it. Alright, good morning everyone. Just kind of want to give you an update today. I've been feeling a little bit better, but I did kind of feel a little bit like irritated this morning. And I'm trying to, like I said earlier, you know, just trying to change how I tell my story a little bit at a time. So I'll have to catch myself mid-thought about just what I've been thinking about. Why am I irritated first thing in the morning? Why do I nitpick at everything? So I'm like, it's okay. It is not the end of the world. You will be fine. Don't let that ruin your day. So, like, having to take out the trash because we didn't put it to the curb last night. And luckily, like, literally, I put it to the curb. Like, I brought it to the curb this morning, and they came 2 minutes afterwards. So I'm very thankful that, you know how many times, yeah, that I forget to do that. But yeah, so I didn't get a chance to wake up and go to the gym this morning. I was just feeling really tired and fatigued. So I decided just to take a rest, like just relax and just take that extra time to sleep and just recuperate myself and then, you know, start my day. So I'm about to walk into work, but I usually drink this breakfast drink that I have. I prefer strawberry, this creamy strawberry one. They have like vanilla and chocolate, but I just like strawberry better. If you're like me and you don't, you wait till the very last minute to do, you know, just to wake up in the morning. I mean, I go to work, I get to work on time. I just wake up at the very last minute that I know I can. So this will help, you know, just satisfy me to lunch. Because I was feeling a little bit irritated as well. If y'all do, I use essential oils sometimes. So lavender is a really good thing as far as like calming and stuff. So I bought this air diffuser. I don't want to take it out because I'm still using it right now. But here's the instruction manual. So it looks like this. It fits in your cup holder and it has a little cord that goes into the your outlet thing. And then this way, because it's already used. You can use this one's outlet. These are two USB cords, but it has the mist coming out of here, and you just put water and oil in it, and then it makes your car smell good, and your lavender calms you down when you feel irritated. So yeah, that's just something I've, you know, it helps me a little bit. I have a little one at my desk too. Just kind of wanted to share that with you. If that's something that may help during your morning commute, make sure that you have nutrition. If you make breakfast, that's even better. Yeah, so good morning. All right, y'all. So it is the next day. It is Saturday. So I'm off, and this is the day I usually dedicate to myself. Recently, I've just been using it to run errands and clean up and stuff, which I'm probably still going to do anyways. But during my meditation, I kind of had a moment. And usually after I meditate, I journal, just kind of, you know, reflecting on what just happened. So I'm really sensitive about what I write in here, but I want to show y'all, you know, what I do. So I'm going to read y'all what I journaled today. All right. I've been dealing well noticing disconnect within myself. I've been dedicating conscious time to figure this out, as well as recording it. I want to be able to know how I align myself and replicate it as much as possible. Today I woke up and decided to remind myself I love me. I took out my crystals and staged my room. I lit my candle and then set my timer to 17 minutes. In complete silence, I let my mind wander freely, without judgment, but allowed boundaries to not go off the deep end. I thought about how I needed to clean my house and rearrange my room. Then I brought my attention to my current state. So my posture, what I can hear, and what I can smell. I caught myself taking short, quick breaths. So I slow down each inhale and exhale. While doing so, I envisioned myself in a grassy area near a creek. For some unknown reason, I felt the need to release the restrictions within myself. So I decided to move. Again, all this is in my vision, you know, during meditation, like my eyes are closed, but you know. So I decided to move, almost like dancing, just dancing the stiffness of the restrictions out of my body. No music, but I could feel myself loosening up with each move. I started to say how much I love me. I could feel my physical state, my throat closing up, and my tears forming. I continued to tell myself that I'm rich and wealthy, and that all I need is the love within myself. Everything I ever need and want, I already possess. Wasn't expecting to do this, but I've been really dealing with allowing emotions coming through. Not sure why. I'm really not sure why. So, that's why I wanted to share that with y'all. The current state that I'm feeling is not sadness. These tears are kind of like releasing the restrictions that I had in my body. Like, I can feel my throat closing up because I shouldn't express how I feel, but I'm realizing that's what's happening. So I'm trying to speak and release because I can feel all these things. And it's okay. It is okay. I can feel myself aligning and where I need to be, and everything, especially that last part, everything that I need and want, I already possess. When I say rich and wealthy, I'm not talking about money and materialistic things.
I'm talking about rich and wealthy with the love and compassion of life. I'm so filled with fears and scares and voids of others. But that's not the importance of life. The importance of life is how I navigate, how I feel, why I want to do these things for myself. And that's been an issue that I've been trying to overcome yet avoid at the same time. So I'm doing this. I have made this my goal to take care of myself, to love myself, and love myself first before anybody else. So I'm realizing that is why I've been feeling so disconnected. It's because I've been avoiding what I need to overcome. Yes, that is my revelation of today. So, thank you.
All right, y'all. So for my last tip, y'all are gonna have to watch my next video. I'm sorry, but yes. So I wanna go in more detail about this last tip that I usually do. I don't do it often. It's my Reiki healing session, but it is something so powerful that I usually wait till I'm like really disconnected to do this. But you don't have to wait like I do. Like, people do it as often as almost they get waxed. So so I'm gonna go more in detail about that on my next video, because I have some clips I want to share with y'all and I don't want too super long. So yes. Well, thank y'all for tuning in. Please click on my next video and please like, comment, and subscribe. This is Jessica Karina coming to you with Jess Help 101. Bye.